Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a vast blue sky with cirrus white clouds and realistic skywritten text from scratch. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Make its width 1920 pixels, its height 1080 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click Create or OK. Open your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the lower left stop and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 42BAFF. Then click OK. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and type in 0048FF. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Go to the bottom of your document and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient tool to the top, then release. Next, we'll create the cirrus clouds. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Let's name it Clouds. Open your eyedropper tool and click the color on the bottom of your document to copy the color. You'll notice that your foreground color is now that color. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Change its blend mode to Pin Light. Next, we'll put the clouds in perspective. First, zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times until it's approximately this size. I zoomed out to 25%. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a top corner and drag it out approximately this much. Then, release. Next, we'll fade the clouds as it gets closer to the bottom. First, let's zoom in a bit by pressing Ctrl or Command and the plus key on your keyboard once. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the clouds. Make sure the foreground color is now black. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Make the size 1100 pixels and the hardness 0%. Then press Enter or Return. Make the opacity 50% and keep the flow 100%. Place your brush tool so it's approximately halfway below the bottom of your document. Then drag it across once. We can zoom back in now. Next, we'll adjust the midtones to give our sky more punch. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Go to the input midtone slider and drag it to the right approximately this much. We're ready to add our text. Open your horizontal type tool and pick an ultra-thin font. I'm using Kozuka Gothic Pro Extra Light. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files below. I'll make its size 190 points, however, feel free to adjust the size depending on the font you pick and the amount of characters in your text. Make it sharp, center alignment, and white for the color. Click on your document and type out your text. If you have more than one line of text, we'll adjust the space between the lines to be approximately this much. To do this, click this icon to open the character paragraph panels. Double-click the large T of your text layer to highlight all your lines. Go to the baseline shift icon and drag it to the right or left to adjust the line spacing. We can close the text panels now. To adjust the space between the characters, also called tracking, press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. We want the tracking to be approximately this much. To center your text on the document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your canvas. Then, click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Ctrl-click or Command-click the large T to make a selection of your text's shape. Open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Click the icon at the upper right corner and click Make Work Path. Keep the default tolerance of 0.5 pixels and click OK. Open back your Layers panel and press B on your keyboard to open your brush tool. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush panel. I already created and saved a Skywriting Clouds brush, which I'll open. I'll show you the settings to create it. First, click Brush Tip Shape. Make the size 125 pixels, the angle 0 degrees, the roundness 100%, and the hardness 0%. Check spacing and make it 25%. Click Shape Dynamics. The size jitter is 100% and all the controls are off. The minimum diameter and the angle jitter are both 0%. The roundness jitter is 30% and the minimum roundness is 25%. Check the flip X and Y jitters. Click Texture. Click the arrow next to the pattern box and click the gear icon. Click Patterns. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current patterns with the new patterns. Scroll down and click Clouds. Check Invert. The scale is 160% and the brightness and contrast are both 0. Check Texture Each Tip and make the blend mode Color Burn. The depth is 100%, the depth jitter is 0%, and the control is off. Click Transfer. If you have an older version of Photoshop, this may be called Other Dynamics. The opacity jitter is 20%, the controls are off, and the flow jitter is 50%. Check Smoothing. Click the New Preset icon to save your settings. Name it Clouds or Skywriting. Check Capture Brush Size in Preset, then click OK. We can close the text panels now. Increase the brush's opacity to 100%. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Skywriting. Hide the text layer and open your Paths panel. Open the flyout menu and click Stroke Path. Make sure the brush tool is selected and Simulate Pressure is not checked. Then click OK. To hide the paths, click on an empty area of your Paths panel. We'll blur our Skywriting text slightly to blend it in better with the sky. But first, we'll convert our Skywriting into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Open back your Layers panel and the Flyout menu. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Next, we'll make our Skywriting in perspective on the sky. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the blur will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Click OK. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the bounding box in approximately this much. Press and hold Shift Control Alt on Windows or Shift Command Option on a Mac as you go back to the corner anchor point. Your cursor should now appear as a white arrowhead. Drag the corner out approximately this much. Go to the bottom center anchor point and drag it up a little. Continue to finesse it until you're happy with its size and perspective. Then press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.